CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 2.
Hello children, how are you all? Hope you are doing great and you and your dear ones are perfectly healthy and safe at home. Do you have your mask on? Good. Please remember to wash your hands often. I can feel that you are missing your school, but don't worry. Sooner, everything will be all right and you will be able to go back to your school and learn there with your friends. Even in school, you have to wear a mask and wash your hands. Promise me? But till then, we are going to have fun. We are going to learn new things in this audio session. To begin with, let me introduce myself. I am your friend Shilpa and I have a story full of magic. Yes, a magic story for you all. I'm sure you have seen a wand, the little thin black stick that a magician always has. He waves it in the air when doing magic and calls out abracadabra. Now, imagine if you had a magical wand, what would you wish for? I would want to have a beautiful bicycle in all the colors of the rainbow. What fun! I would ride it in the open air to school, to the park, up a hill and down again with the wind blowing in my hair. Yay! What would you ask the wand for? Think about it. Today, I am going to narrate a story of a little mischievous monkey who got a magic wand. Let's see what he wants and see that whether he becomes happy after getting what he wished for. Open page number 29 of your Marigold English textbook and find yourself. If you don't have the book, it doesn't matter. You can still listen to the story. Later on, you can read it when you get the book or a photocopy of the story. So don't worry at all. Let's listen to the story. The title of the story is I Want. Once upon a time, there lived a little monkey in a big forest. He could run, jump, play, and climb trees. Just like you. And just like you, the little monkey would say, I want to be big. I want to be strong. I'm sure, children, you also say it sometimes. I want to be a painter. I want to be a dancer. And so on. Well, one day, a wise woman hears the monkey. She gave him a magic wand and tells him, all your wishes can come true. The monkey sees a giraffe who stretches his long neck to eat leaves at the top of the trees. What fun, says the monkey. The giraffe is standing on the ground, yet he can see the top of the trees. I want a long neck too, says little monkey, and he waves the magic wand. Oh my goodness, there is a loud sound. Bop! Oh, what is happening? What is happening? Little monkey's neck is growing. It grows and grows and keeps on growing longer, just like the giraffe's. Little monkey is happy with his long neck. He twists and turns his neck. He looks up at the clouds, down at the ground. His feet seem a long, long way down. Little monkey goes to the lake to see himself in the water. An elephant fills his trunk with water and blows it all over himself. What fun, says the monkey. I want to do that too, says little monkey. And he waves the magic wand. Oh my goodness! There is a loud sound. Bang! Yes, bang! He grows a trunk. He's very happy. He fills his trunk with water and blows it all over himself. He pulls out sugarcane from the ground. It is so much fun. Next, little monkey sees a zebra. What fun, says the monkey. I want stripes like those too. And he waves the magic wand. Oh my goodness, there is a loud sound. Whizz! Little monkey has stripes all over his body, just like the zebra. He is very, very happy. He goes to the river to try out his new trunk. As he looks down, he sees himself in the river. Mother! Help! Help! A monster! He cries. That's not a monster, says his mother. That's you. You want a giraffe's neck, an elephant's trunk, and stripes like zebra. Don't you remember? Little monkey cries and cries. I look awful. I want to be myself again, he says. Again, there is a pop, a bang, and a whiz. Little monkey is himself again. He jumps for joy. He feels his neck. Oh, good. It is short now. He feels his nose. Oh, good. It is back to normal. He looks at his hands and feet. Oh, good. No stripes. He throws the magic wand into the river. He never wants to be anyone else again. Dear children, here the story ends. So, did you like the story? Isn't it interesting? Imagine the monkey with the long neck, trunk, and stripes. Do you think he was looking good or funny? Think about it. What a wonderful story. By now, you must have got some idea about the story. I will again read aloud the story in parts and you will act out the animals. You are a monkey. Get up. Jump around. Lift your hands and scratch your sides. Fun. A little monkey says, I want to be big. I want to be strong. A wise woman hears him and gives him a magic wand and tells him, all your wishes can come true. Dear children, what does the little monkey want to become? Yes, he wants to become big and strong. Will his wish come true? Let's see. So, a wise woman hears him. What does she give him? She gives him a magic wand. A magic wand is a stick used by fairies to do magic. So the lady gives him the magic wand and tells him that all his wishes will come true. Next, the monkey sees a giraffe. Now you are a giraffe. Act like a giraffe who stretches his long neck to eat leaves at the top of the trees. I want a long neck, says little monkey. Pop! His neck grows long, just like the giraffe's. Little monkey is happy. Dear children, have you seen a giraffe? What is so special about a giraffe? It has a long neck. Its long neck helps it to eat leaves, which are at the top of the trees. Since the monkey thinks of becoming big, so he wishes to have a long neck like giraffe. And the magic wand does the magic. And pow! The little monkey gets a long neck, just like the giraffe. Is he happy or sad? Think about it. Yes, he becomes very happy after getting the long neck. Let's read ahead. An elephant fills his trunk with water. Now, you are an elephant. You have a long nose. It is called a trunk. You suck in the water and whoosh, try to blow water all over yourself. I think it is fun. I want to do that too, says little monkey. Bang! He grows a trunk. He is very happy. Now, the monkey sees an elephant. And, dear children, an elephant is very strong. You know, elephant is very strong? Yes, an elephant has a strong trunk. What does an elephant do with its trunk? Think about it. I think you know. What does an elephant do with its trunk? Yes, it uses its trunk to fill water, hold things, and breathe also. You know, it can pick up a tree with its trunk. And it can also pick up a needle with its trunk. Did you know that? Isn't it amazing? So, the monkey sees an elephant using his trunk to fill water and putting it all over its body. Actually, the elephant was taking bath. So now the monkey also wishes to blow water on himself. And guess what? The magic wand does the magic. Bang! And the little monkey grows a trunk, just like the elephant. Is he happy or sad? Think about it. Think. Yes, correct. He is very happy because he gets what he wants. Next, little monkey sees a zebra and says, I want stripes like those. Whizz! Again magic. Little monkey has stripes all over his body, just like the zebra. Now, the monkey sees a zebra. You know, a zebra has stripes all over its body. What is the color of the stripes? Think about it. Yes, the color of the stripes of zebra is white and black. A zebra crossing also has white and black stripes. So, the monkey wants to have stripes like zebra. What happens next? Yes, the magic wand does the magic again. Whizz! The monkey has stripes all over its body, just like a zebra. Again, he becomes happy. He goes to the river to try out his new trunk. As he looks down, he sees himself in the river. Mother, help, a monster, he cries. Dear children, as he looks down, he sees his own image. So now he sees a monkey with a long neck, trunk, and stripes on his body. Funny, isn't it? You can imagine how he must be looking. Actually, he gets scared looking at himself and thinks as if a monster is there. But is there a monster? Did he see a monster? No, it's the monkey only. Looking like a monster. Next, that's not a monster, says his mother. That's you. You want a giraffe's neck, an elephant's trunk, and stripes like a zebra. Don't you remember? Little monkey cries and cries. I look awful. I want to be myself again, he says. There is a pop. Bang and whiz, magic. So now tell me, why does the monkey cry? His all wishes got fulfilled, but still he is not happy. Let me tell you why. Now, when the little monkey cries, looking at himself. Then his mother explains him that since he wished for a long neck, a trunk and stripes, so now he's looking like this. He's looking like a monster. The little monkey feels that now he's looking awful. Awful means not good, ugly. So now he wishes to be himself. And again the magic wand does the magic. So let's see what happens next. Little monkey is himself again. He jumps for joy. He throws the magic wand into the river. He never wants to be anyone else again. Dear children, the little monkey becomes himself again because this is what he wished for. Now, he wants to be himself. He throws away the magic wand into the river and now he doesn't want to be like anyone else. Dear children, why do you think that he doesn't want to be like anyone else? Think? Yes. He started loving himself. He realized that you cannot be happy by becoming anyone else. We should be happy the way God has created us. Yes, we should grow to be big and strong, but we should not wish for stupid things. I hope you liked the story and I hope you understood the story well. Now, let us revise some of the new words we found in the story. I will speak each word 2 times. You please listen carefully and repeat after me. Monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y. Monkey. Magic. M-A-G-I-C. Magic. Wish. W-I-S-H. Wish. Wand. W-A-N-D. Wand. Giraffe. G-I-R-A-F-F-E. See, the spelling is giraffe, G-I-R-A-F-F-E, but the sound of G is J. J as in jump, joy, jelly. The next word is strong. S-T-R-O-N-G, strong. Here, S-T-R is a blend sound and we speak it as str. Str. Let's speak more words with str sound. Stretches. Stretches. S-T-R-E-T-C-H-E-S. Stretches. Stripes. Stripes. S-T-R-I-P-E-S. Stripes. Zebra. Zebra. Z-E-B-R-A. Zebra. Z like zoom. Z-O-O-M. Zoom. Zip. Z-I-P. Zip. Zoo. Z-O-O. Zoo. Now, let's do an activity. I would be reading out some sentences for you. You have to tell whether they are true or false. So the first one is, the little monkey wants to be big and strong. Tell whether this is true or false. This sentence is true. Yes, correct. Next, a wise woman doesn't hear him. So, is it true or false? This sentence is false. So, the next sentence is, she gives him a wand. Is it true or false? Yes, this sentence is true because the woman gives him a magic wand. Next sentence. The giraffe stretches his long neck. Is this sentence true or false? The giraffe stretches his long neck. Yes, it is. It is a correct sentence. The elephant has no trunk. Is this sentence true? Think about it. No, it is not true. The elephant has a trunk. Remember the long nose which an elephant has? The zebra has stripes. Is this sentence true? Yes, it is. A zebra has black and white stripes. The little monkey sees a monster in the river. Is this sentence true? Does the monkey see a monster in the river? No, this sentence is not true. He actually sees his image in the river and gets scared. So this sentence is not true. Alright, now let's recall the story and let me know if you can answer my questions. So here is my first question for you. What does little monkey want to be? What does little monkey want to be? Yes, you are right. The little monkey wants to be big and strong. The little monkey wants to be big and strong. Next question is, who hears him? So the question is, who hears him? And the correct answer is, a wise woman hears him. A wise woman hears him. So the third question is, how does an elephant have a bath? How does an elephant have a bath? An elephant fills his trunk with water and blows it all over himself. An elephant fills his trunk with water and blows it all over himself. So you are right. Next question is, does the zebra have spots or stripes? So dear children, tell me, the zebra have spots or stripes? Yes, the zebra has stripes, black and white stripes. Why does little monkey want to be himself again? Why does the little monkey want to be himself again? So the correct answer is, the little monkey feels that he is looking like a monster, so he wants to be himself again. The little monkey feels that he is looking like a monster, so he wants to be himself again. Dear children, in this story we read about many animals. Let us recall all the animals. So we had one monkey, one giraffe, one elephant and one zebra. Imagine if we had five monkeys, then we would have added S in the end of the spelling of monkey and said five monkeys. M-O-N-K-E-Y-S, monkeys. So what I am doing is, for many monkeys, I'll add S in the end of the spelling of monkey. Okay, now tell me, if we had five elephants, then we would have added S in the end of the spelling of elephant and said five elephants. E-L-E-P-H-A-N-T-S, elephants. So we are adding S in the end of the spelling of the elephant. If we had four zebras, then we would have added S in the end of the spelling of zebra and said four zebras. Z-E-B-R-A-S, zebras. If we had two giraffes, then we would have added S in the end of the spelling of giraffe and said two giraffes. G-I-R-A-F-F-E-S, giraffes. So it's like one frog and four frogs, F-R-O-G-S. One dog, three dogs, D-O-G-S, dogs. I hope you all have enjoyed this so far. So now I have another activity planned for you. You can do it later on. On a sheet of paper, make a list of the names of your family members and friends. Write at least 10 names. In the front of the names, write down a sentence to describe them or what you like about them. For example, Sunil is so tall. Ruksana is really good. In this way, write down one sentence each for all the 10 names which you have written. Do it later on. Also, try to write few lines on your favorite bird or animal. You can take help of the following sentences. Like, first sentence can be, my favorite animal or bird is dash. For example, I can tell you, my favorite animal is a dog. So the next sentence will be like, I like it because dash. You can continue the sentence and write whatever you want to write about it. Third will be, it eats. So whatever the animal eats, you can write about that. I think it looks like dash. So the resemblance, you can tell about the resemblance. Dear children, it's time to say goodbye. I hope you enjoyed the story and learned a lesson from it, that we should love ourselves. We should not try to be like others. We should not copy others. Be yourself. Keep loving yourself. Dear children, I will soon meet you with another fun-filled learning lesson. Till then, take good care of yourself and your loved ones. Love animals and do take their care also. Give water and food to animals. Be happy and safe.
You are just listening to curriculum-based programs, Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. This program was recorded by Bati Langlingdo and technically assisted by Soumya Malik. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.